What's up, guys? I'm checking out this Juice WRLD video. I'm a little late to it, but it's Juice WRLD, Eminem, and Benny Blanco. Lace it. Let's get right into it. Oh, yeah, I do stream on Twitch, by the way. If you want to check out my Twitch, I stream every single day. Twitch.tv/Boytastic. That's my Twitch. Yeah. Coding by the Laces, I've Been Purple Raining. Okay, okay. It's kind of like the Prince song, no? Like Purple Rain, you know what I'm saying? I think that's what he's going for. Pop a few chases. I've been in the matrix. None of this shit makes sense. All you humans basic. You ain't got on training. Coding by the cases. I've been purple raining. Stressed out, so I tend to take meds. The devil told me good show. Break a leg. All these painkillers. So this shit hit hard, considering, like, you know, obviously what happened to Juice. First of all, RIP Juice WRLD 999. RIP Juice WRLD. And obviously, like, the lines he says every single song, I mean, it's kind of given, like, how he's going to come off in these songs, you know? It's kind of like his whole topic when it comes to him making music is just, it's about drugs, you know, this kind of stuff. Obviously, it kind of rose me weird a little bit. Obviously considering how he died, things like that, for Grade A to, like, put out songs like this, you know, that's why I'm kind of hoping that Eminem does, like, a different kind of thing, because if he's talking about drugs and stuff like Juice WRLD is, it's kind of, I don't know, it kind of rubs me the wrong way, because it's like, I don't know, they're like, Grade A's making money off of Juice WRLD's death, and he's just constantly talking about the drugs and stuff. At some point, it's kind of like, okay, cool, you need to do something else. It feels kind of scummy to just keep talking about drugs over and over in his songs when he's, you know, obviously passed away due to drugs. So that's just my thoughts on it anyway. Killers, I got a pair of broken legs. All these perks I popped, we thought I was planning to break my neck. Painkillers, I got a pair of broken legs. The devil told me good show, break a leg. All these painkillers, I got a pair of broken legs. All these perks I popped, we thought I was planning to break my neck. Oh. Hey, man, I'm hungry for this shit like I ain't ate yet. You wish that you could have what I could have, you could just say that. If you ain't my little bitch, then bitch, them combos, you could save that. These niggas think they invincible till they see them blows and they may
be. Okay. Good verse, he's floating on that one. It makes sense.
I can't lie, this is a very smart chorus. This chorus is hard. Not that Juice WRLD isn't good at choruses, because Juice WRLD goes off on choruses, bro. I can't name one Juice WRLD song that has a bad chorus, if I'm honest with you. Like, every single chorus he always has, he knows how to bring you in, you know what I mean? He constantly knows how to bring you into a song, and he's just, no matter what, you're going to be listening to it again at some point. Or, like, I don't know. It's like, Juice WRLD just, he's the master of just constantly creating good choruses, making you want to listen to the song again, you know what I'm saying? And so, and also, one thing, I'm going to say this first, so I can just get this done, this whole topic over with. I like the fact that I think Juice WRLD, this is my opinion, of course. There's no, like, probably, there's probably not very many studies or anything like that about it, but I feel like Juice's songs have helped a lot of people. You know what I mean? Like, it helped people, you know, relate to him and kind of be like, oh, I'm going through the same thing. Oh, you know what I mean? It's like, I don't know, I feel like it's something you can relate to. Like, I feel like if I was on drugs, right, and I'm going through the same thing he's doing, and he's constantly talking about how, you know, he's struggling and demons and, you know, all this stuff, right? I feel like it would help the other person cope a little bit, you know what I mean? It'd help the other person, I don't know, come to terms with it, which, honestly, yeah, I mean, only problem I have with it is I couldn't really see how somebody would want to quit doing it, you know what I mean? I feel like at the same time, it might be kind of like promoting, you know, people to keep doing drugs. At the same time, he passed away from it. So I feel like at that end of the day, it's like you're going through the same thing, and then he died from it, you kind of be like, oh, shoot. The same thing can happen to me. You know what I mean? That's how I see it. None of this shit makes sense. All you humans basic, you ain't got home training. Coding by the case, yeah. I've been purple rain. You pop some ecstasy first, it gets progressively worse. Ooh. Try your best to reverse. Unsuccessfully flirting with certain death and reverting to your promethazine urge. The fucking devil, he lurks. Lose your best friend, he smirks. Wake up and everything. Lose your best friend, he smirks, bro. All this, like, all this devil talk is like, it's such a, like, personally, I believe in the demons. I believe in demons. I believe in ghosts, afterlife, you know, things like that. I do believe in demons. Honestly, Juice WRLD helped me believe in demons, to be honest. Like, a lot of the stuff he talks about is a lot about demons. Like, he's trapped in his head, you know, the demons are trying to escape, you know, things like that. I think everybody has their own demons. I do stand by that. Do I have my own demons? I'm sure I do somewhere deep down that I haven't found yet. But I think everybody in life has demons of some sort, no matter how extreme they are. Obviously, Juice WRLD probably had the extreme demons because he had to do the drugs, he had to deal with it. You know, the whole just being famous and, you know, all this other stuff. So, I mean, at the end of the day, bro, I believe in demons. I think everybody has demons deep down, even if you haven't found them yet. And, you know, it's a tough subject because obviously Juice WRLD struggled a lot, you know, with this whole drugs and being famous and having to deal with all that on top of it. So, thing hurts. And as you spiral downward, listen, yeah. I know just how it is when what? You start slow, then before you notice it, now you're mixing what? Oxys without prescription, yeah. Cough medicine, Valium with them. Damn. But ain't that how addiction sort of works? They call it lean because you gravitate and lean towards the purple. They call it lean because you lean towards it and grab the perk, bro. I knew Eminem was going to kill this, let's be honest, bro. I think we all knew Eminem was going to kill this song. I think at this point, everybody should know, like, obviously Eminem went through his whole, you know, drug thing too. He had a whole relapse. He pretty much almost, he got very, very close to dying from overdosing. Some people should know that, I believe. He probably mentions it in the song at some point, right? You'd think, I mean, it's a big part of his life, bro. I'm pretty sure he's at a point where he couldn't, I think he said he couldn't rap. Like, it actually messed up, like, his talking and stuff. That's what I'm saying. Now you can afford to serve Percocet and hit them. But ain't that how addiction sort of works? They call it lean because you gravitate and lean towards the purpose, the blessing or the curse of fame. Because now you can afford to serve. Yep, there it is. Percocet, but that ain't what you meant when you said that you're in it for the perks. Develop a habit. What a line there, bro. What a line. He talked about the perks, obviously, like perk 30s, perk 10s, whatever. I'm not sure exactly how it works. I've heard like little bits about perks, but, and then he also said the perks, like benefits, you know, like it out of that, need a Xanax, not a rap, so you pop it before you record it first. Your buzz wear down, yeah, like a rabbit out of hat, makes you want to pull your hair out. Fentanyl, like a rabbit out of hat. If you want to pull your hair out, you know, a rabbit can also be called a hair. Yeah, I'm not gonna try to decipher this whole entire thing. It's a little cringe. I want you guys to build a rabbit. See, Demerol, wanna pull your hair out. Fentanyl, Oxy, Demerol would possibly got shock G. Roxy, codeine and lean is probably what got Lil Peep and ODB. So many who ODB, way too young to go see me. I was lucky, my escape was narrow window. Now think I take it for granted that I'm still here. Synthetic heroin, you tried to kill me, then you murdered Jared, didn't you, bitch? Piece of shit. Whoa, you, whoa. We lost gangsta boo and Pimpsy. Whoa. I got chills. I don't know why that gave me chills, if I'm honest with you, but I got chills. Right when he said, like, you killed Jared, didn't you? Stupid, you know what I mean? That's way too hard. Young to go see me. I was lucky, my escape was narrow window. Now think I take it for granted that I'm still here. Synthetic heroin, you tried to kill me, then you murdered Jared, didn't you, bitch? Piece of shit. Thanks, you know, to you, now like we lost gangsta boo and Pimpsy, Prince and Michael Mixon, Nike will get prescription vikes, addictions like a fucking vicious cycle. Eminem man, you need to go that hard, bro. Come on, man. Yo, this might be his best verse in a long time, man. This might be his best verse in a long time, bro. I can't think of a verse that's any better than this. I mean, obviously, you got Godzilla, bro. I mean, Godzilla, he went off, you know what I'm saying? But honestly, I can't think of too many more verses that Eminem's had in, like, the recent times that's been as this good. You know what I'm saying? Like, he killed this, bro. He killed this song. The verse is going absolutely insane. Bro. R.I.P. Juice WRLD, man. Let's get that right off the bat. I'm sorry I didn't say that in the beginning. I should have said that, like, immediately in the beginning, but Let's just go ahead and say it now. RIP Juice WRLD. RIP Jerry Higgins, whatever you want to call him, bro. RIP to him, man. He went through a lot, bro. Went through a lot. And this song went actually insane. Like, it's a very, 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 very good song. I find when Eminem makes a verse, that's actually like, it's more like him speaking from his heart. Not that any of his verses are bad. Let's be honest. I mean, how many bad verses does Eminem have, bro? But I feel like when he's talking about like drugs and, you know, his life that like is close to his heart, he goes off, bro. I feel like that's how I see it anyway. But yeah, this song's really good. This song's really good. I give it like easily just a 10 out of 10. I mean, there's nothing wrong, nothing bad about it. It's a really good song. One thing I'm worried about is like replay value. You know what I mean? Like, when I listen to this song again and again and again and again over and over, at some point it's going to get old. I mean, you can't really say a song's bad because, oh, you don't listen to it many times. Blah, blah, blah. I mean, you know what I mean? It's like, whatever. Anyway, appreciate you guys for being here. I hope you guys made it to the end of the video. If you guys did make it to the end of the video, make sure to hit the subscribe, like, comment, everything. I do stream on Twitch every single day. I'll put the link down below. It's twitch.tv/boytastic. That's my Twitch. I stream Overwatch, Fortnite, pretty much everything, bro. It's a variety stream. Variety streams galore all the time. High entertainment. Guys, you want to check it out, again, it's down below. My Instagram, stuff like that, will also be on my Twitch. So if you click my Twitch, then you'll get to the other stuff and all that good stuff. So anyway, appreciate you guys for being here. Appreciate you guys for watching the video, staying this long. Shout out to you guys. Peace.